Welcome to episode number 3 in the automation series. In this video, we are going to talk about reports and analytics. If I compare myself to 10 years ago, 10 years ago, I cared as a business owner about sales, about marketing, you know, legal, customer service. I cared about everything except reports. When other CEOs talked to me about reporting, I said, you know what, we're not big enough for reporting. And that was a huge mistake. 10 years later, which is, you know, when I started to evolve more in the business world, I understood that without reporting, you're flying in the dark. You have a fighter jet that you're flying, you know, very, very fast, but you have no clue what's ahead of you, what's in your right, left. You know nothing. And this is why we need reporting. In this session, I'm going to show you an example of the dashboard that I'm using on a weekly basis in my company. In my company, I am the owner, but I am not the CEO. Carol is the CEO of our company. I am the owner. I meet with her once a week and we go over everything that we have in the company. So in this video, I'm going to give you a glance of how our dashboard looks like. We have multiple dashboards. In this session, we worked on a demo environment to show you how a dashboard looks like and what me as the owner, what I'm looking for when I'm watching those reports. So as you can see, this is the report. Of course, the numbers and the names and everything that you will see there is absolutely a demo version, so it's not real. The first chart that I want to see is how many paid invoices we had for every month. In a real environment, I will have invoices. I will have another chart that will show me invoices that are paid and also invoices that are stuck in account receivables. So it will show me basically how much we're selling, how much we received, and how much is spending. Right now, for example, because it looks like recession is starting, our account receivables jumped very high. And without a good report, I would just see the invoices and I will say it's all good. We're selling, you know, actually last month was our best month ever. But in terms of account receivables, there is a huge problem. So without reporting, you won't be able to see it. I also like to see tickets that's coming from Zoho Desk, which is our customer service system. I like to see how many tickets we have in the system, how many got escalated to a manager, how many are right now on hold. And in our system, on hold means that the manager is supposed to review. And also how many tickets are currently open. If in the real system, I will have 41 tickets that are on hold, which means a manager supposed to review and is not, that's an emergency, which means the managers are not doing their job. And of course, 225 open tickets, it's bankruptcy. So all those are huge signals that your business is going down. Okay, so it's very, very important to have that. Now, one big thing that people don't know about analytics, there is a way to have one dashboard that collects information from Zoho CRM, Zoho Desk, Zoho Projects, Zoho Books, and so on. So there is no problem to have one dashboard with information from multiple sources. I heard many times professionals telling us that it's impossible, but as you can see here, this information coming from Zoho Books and this information coming from Zoho Desk. Okay, so it is possible and we do it all day long. You can see here also deals, for example, that are stuck in the proposal stage. In our experience, when you're sending a proposal and it's there for more than 2 days, something is going on because we don't send proposals to people that don't say, please send me a proposal, I'm ready to proceed. So those supposed to be almost closed deals. So if the proposal is stuck more than 2 days in this stage, it's a red alert. We need to call the person immediately. Okay, something is going on. And those are sweet deals that you don't want to lose, okay? Because you already spent so much work on them. In lots of companies, actually we had one company that I worked with that we saved their business. They had a long process of sales. They invested insane amount of money on the lead cycle, driving the leads to the business, but there was no money in the company. And eventually, based on this report, the same one that I'm showing you right now, we saw that the people that are sending the proposals are not doing a good job of following post-proposal. And therefore, the company was losing an insane amount of deals. So just this one report saved the company from bankruptcy. And they knew that they don't need to have more leads to the business. They just need to close them. On the right side, you have deals in process. That's basically everything that is my pipeline. It's not lost, it's not won, it's traveling in between, and you can see the amounts, you can see the dates, you can see everything. So that's beautiful. Based on that, we were able to identify, based on our data and our customers' data, we were able to see a few months ago, that the market is going to recession. And I did a video about the market is going to recession much before Bloomberg and, you know, CNN and all the big websites started to talk about it, because we saw the data and we saw it's coming. On the left side, you will have deals that won, and I care about the numbers, not the monetary value in this case, but of course we can also have the monetary value. I want to see the numbers, how much won, and it's per day of the week. Based on that, we can see patterns that, you know, Fridays and Monday morning will be usually slow days, midweek better, and therefore you know how to allocate your manpower and where to put more stress on the system and where to relax a bit. This is how many deals were lost. Usually when you will have spikes of new manpower, you will see that you have more lost leads. So it's good to know what to expect based on this data. On the left side, you have a critical component, and it's how much time it takes the team to respond to new inquiries or new tickets. In this case, you can see that most of them are being answered in the first 2 hours, and that's what should be. More than 2 hours, you're starting to lose your customer service, and you're losing also your leads. The leads will go somewhere else. 12 hours, 2 to 5 hours, 5, and so on. And eventually more than 24 hours. And that's for the first response. If it was a real company, this company is in bankruptcy. There is no way that this company can survive. You know, giving, you know, most of the customers will get customer service that is more than 24 hours, or new leads that getting responses after 24 hours. It's horrible. In this case, by the way, when we have companies that have massive amounts of incoming leads, we are automating the entire lead cycle. So when the lead comes in, we will send an automated text message or an email or WhatsApp message that will say, "Hey, Lior, I received your lead inquiry. I'm right now on the phone with another client. Please fill this form so I will get more information before I'm going to give you a call." And then the person will fill the form. After he's filling the form, there will be another automated email or message. Say, "Hey, thank you for filling the form. I'm happy that you filled it. It's amazing. Please book time for a meeting here." Now, the client thinks that a human is actually talking to him when no one knows about this person. And your system is able to manage the lead in a way that he thinks that he's being dealt with while your team is doing other things. And it's also being used as a very good filtration system for companies that want to deal only with leads and prospects that are responsive. Okay, so there are different ways that we are dealing with those cases. Sometimes it's adding more manpower, but my favorite, of course, automation. On the right side, you can see for the specific period, which this is a quarter, you can see working hours for each employee, and those will be billable hours. You can do it for billable hours, clock in, clock out, whatever it is. And of course, once you know what's going on in your company, it's amazing. We also have reports that we didn't create here because creating those reports is time consuming. We have in our system reports that are more about project management, time allocation for each employee, how many hours employees are allocated to projects and how much is the actual time that they spent on tasks. Bottom line, in order for the business owner or a manager to run its department or its company, it must have quality reports. And the reports that you will get is out of the box with Zoho, all those, it's amazing and it's cool, but I don't think that it's enough. The reason is that from all those dashboards and all those reports, you need to have very specific pieces of details that will come in front of you, such as this dashboard, that I know what I am looking for in order to manage my company in a good way, instead of starting to click on million dashboard and collect small pieces of information. Okay, so usually when we have new clients for analytics purposes, we are going to create an architecture session. We are going to collect information what they like to see. Based on that, we are structuring the data that we are collecting from the users or the leads or the employees. And from that, we are going to generate quality reporting that will help you run your business.